Good morning, everybody. My name is Kenneth, and I teach my 219,000 followers on TikTok how to invest, trade stocks if they want to, and live below their means. And YouTube has this great new feature now where they show you what topics in your niche, which would be finance for me, are trending right now and people have a lot of questions about. And this morning, the first one that popped up was investing for beginners. And I was like, well, put the camera on the tripod because I got a lot to say about this. In fact, it's one of the things that I teach most of my followers a lot about is investing for beginners. That's the majority of my followers on TikTok and maybe here on YouTube as well. So if you're new to investing, you want to start investing, but you're not sure what to invest in, this is the right video for you. I think a lot of fear that we have with money in the stock market and investing comes from the fact that our parents were never maybe able to invest. So it's not something that we heard about growing up. It's not something that was talked about a lot growing up in a variety of different households of a variety of different incomes. I think a lot of lower income families never talked about it because it was embarrassing, or they were insecure about money, or they didn't want to talk about it, or they didn't have the time to talk about it because the parents were working so many jobs and they would come home and they had a very limited amount of time to themselves. Or just that they didn't know because they weren't taught about it. The schools don't teach it. Their parents couldn't teach them. Now they have kids. They can't teach their kids. On the other hand, you have a lot of wealthier families who also don't talk to their kids about money because those parents don't want their kids to grow up being spoiled little brats who are like, well, we know you have the money, so why don't you buy us the toys? So for a variety of different reasons, from a variety of different households, it's not always something that's talked about. And it's not always something that parents pass on to their kids. Here's what you should do. Here's how you should invest. Coupled with the fact that schools also don't teach it, we end up with a society of people who go, stock market? What? How do I? I don't even know. Is it safe? What stocks do I buy? I can run you through horror story after horror story of people who say, well, I don't touch the stock market because my uncle lost everything investing. And you know, you push them a little bit, and well, what did they invest in? And it's always like, oh, well, the guy at his barbershop or his mechanic told him about a stock and he dumped all of his money into it and he lost everything overnight. It's like, well, hey, that's not investing. That's not even trading. That's just gambling. That's just dumping your money in and going, oh man, I hope this goes up. That's not investing. And when you kind of talk them through it and you show them some numbers, which I'll be putting up here on the screen throughout this video, they go, oh, okay, I get it now. Horror stories also from people who, you know, dumped all of their money into just a handful of stocks, didn't know about index funds, didn't know about Roth IRAs, didn't know about really any of that stuff. So I'm gonna try to cover the basics here as I think I do best on TikTok, and we'll try to see how it does here on YouTube as well. And I'm gonna talk to you guys about something that I talk about a lot, which is the foundation and building a solid foundation first. But the first part of investing for beginners is, what kind of account do you want? Do you want a Roth IRA or do you want an individual brokerage account? Now, there's gonna be images on the screen here showing you how to open both of these accounts at any brokerage you want. I'm gonna use Schwab. I used to use TD Ameritrade, but Schwab bought TD Ameritrade. So their website, TD Ameritrade's website, is still up and it's still running, but you know, you might see this video 4 years from now and it might just be Schwab. But generally it's gonna be the same on any brokerage. Individual brokerage account means that you put in money as much as you want, you invest whatever you want, but if you sell a stock for a profit, if you get a dividend, even if you reinvest that dividend, you're gonna owe taxes on it. A Roth IRA means that already taxed money is going into this account. What does it mean, already taxed? It's money that you earned through your job. So you work in a restaurant or CVS or in an office somewhere and you get taxes, you pay taxes every year on the money you earn. That money you deposit into the Roth IRA. It has a max. The government knows it's a good deal, which is why they cap it. $6,500 is the most you can put in. And there are income limits as well. I think it's something around $150,000 per year. If you make more than that, you have to open a traditional IRA, but we'll get into that later because I have a feeling, as we know with statistics and numbers, most people make under 150 in this country. So you open the Roth IRA, you put in already taxed dollars up to 6,500. Now, the mistake a lot of people make when opening a Roth IRA is they think the Roth IRA is the investment. So I've gotten messages from people who said, hey, for the last 3 years, I've been putting in $2,000 or $3,000 and I open up the account and it hasn't grown. It hasn't gone down, but it hasn't grown either. What's the deal with that? Everyone says it's such a great investment. It's unchanged. And I was like, what investment did you make? And they're like, the Roth IRA. Roth IRA isn't the investment. Roth IRA is just the account. Stocks have to then go in it, or index funds, mutual funds, investments go in that account. And they go, oh, fuck. You know, they like, you see them slowly realize the mistake they've made because nobody ever told them. People just said, open a Roth IRA. And they go, oh, that's the account, that's the investment, opens the account, puts the money in, doesn't realize. So you have to decide what you want. It's tax-free in retirement. So after like 59 and a half, you can start taking money out tax-free. Now people always go, well, I want that money now. Then you open an individual account and a Roth IRA. Or let's say you have more than $6,500 to invest. Let's say you can invest $10,000 a year if you're very fortunate. Well, the max for the Roth IRA is $6,500. In 2024, it's going to be $7,000. That's the max. So if you have $10,000 to invest, it spills over into the individual account, which, yes, you'll pay taxes on, but better than nothing. You know, it's better than not investing at all, and you have extra money to invest. Now what goes in that fund? Now that you've seen the images, you know how to open the individual, you know how to open the Roth IRA, what investments go in it? And I think this is the most important part of this video. What goes in the account? I'm a big believer in this tiered house sort of approach, or pyramid approach, really. But we have the foundation first. And everybody knows the foundation is the most important part of the home. It's the safest, it's the heaviest, it's the largest part of the home. It holds up the house. What goes in that first level of the home, of your investments? The largest, the strongest, the safest. It's not Apple stock. It's not some high-paying dividend stock. It's not some speculative penny stock someone told you about on TikTok. It's an S&P 500 index fund. I'm going to show some on the screen here right now. The one that I own is SPLG. It charges an expense ratio, which is a fee. It's 0.02%, I think, off the top of my head. $10,000 in the fund, if that's what you have, your fees are like $2. So don't worry too much about the fees for S&P 500 index funds. They're all relatively low. And you only need one. People always go, well, if it's so good, I'll just buy all three. The big three are SPLG, VOO, and SPY. But they all invest in the exact same thing, which is the S&P 500. They all charge expense ratios. Their dividends are mostly the same. Their growth is exactly the same. Everything is the same. So why would you buy three of the exact same thing and pay fees when your growth is going to be identical on all three? It's not like one is better than the other. They're all the same. So you pick your S&P 500 index fund. That's your foundation. We pick it as the foundation because it has the longest track record. It has the most research behind it. We know that generally speaking, these funds will go up 9 to 12% per year on average. It doesn't mean every single year it will go up 9 or 12%. We also have to factor in things such as inflation, which means you can deduct 2 to 3%. I don't know if you heard that bird out there, but he's disrupting my flow. S&P 500, largest investment. On average, 7 to 9%. Annual returns. Some years it'll go down, some years it'll go up, some years it'll go up more than 7%. This year, for example, I believe it's up 15%. Other years, there might be a recession. That might be the year you start investing. You dump a whole bunch of money into a fund and it tanks. And you go, oh my God, what am I doing? What is this stock market? And you sell and you say, never again. Wrong mistake. Wrong thing to do. The S&P 500 investing isn't for tomorrow, it's not for the next 2 weeks, it's not for the next year, it's for the next 30 years. You're investing in the stock market for retirement. So I know it's scary when it's your hard-earned money, but when you're putting your hard-earned money into these funds and you see it losing value, don't panic. The whole point of the S&P 500 index fund is that it's diversified for you. And for many people, that's their only investment. Is it right for me? No. Is it right for you? Maybe. And that's fine, because there's no size one size fits all when it comes to the stock market and investing. You have to find what's best for you as an investor. So you might say, you know what? I want to invest. I know the importance of investing, but I just don't care. So I'm going to do index fund, S&P 500. I'm going to buy one S&P 500 index fund, and that's all I'm ever going to invest in for the rest of my life. I'm never going to buy anything else. If that's right for you, that's good. If you look at the stock market and you say, I want more, and I want more